So once again, good morning, friends. Now we will be moving on to the next part of this evaporation unit, that is measurement of the evaporation. We have earlier learned how to measure the precipitation, how to measure the infiltration, how to measure the other aspects of the hydrological cycle. Now we are moving into the next and very important aspect, that is the measurement of the evaporation, because ultimately we need our ultimate goal is to get the quantity of runoff or quantity of the flood, and the flood is needed for the design of the hydraulic structures. So therefore the measurement of the evaporation is very important. There are three basic methods of the measuring the evaporation. The first is by using the evaporimeter data, or they are also called as the evaporation pans. Karke ek instrument rehta hai. With that instrument, we can find out the evaporation quantity. There are certain empirical equations also, certain formulas also. With the help of those formulas also, we can find out the evaporation, like the Penman's formula, etc. There are certain analytical methods also. They are the water budget method, energy budget method. We will see one by one. First, we will see the evaporation pans or the evaporimeter. Okay. So these are also called as the pan evaporimeter. Here the sketch of that evaporimeter is there, or photograph of that evaporimeter, or the pan evaporimeter is there, or these are also called as the evaporation pans. They are commonly used as evaporation measuring instruments because they are not costly. They are very easy to handle. They have a diameter of 20 to 25 centimeters. We will see one by one. The depth is 20 to 25 centimeters and a diameter of 1 to 1.25 meters. A water is stored in these evaporating pans, and the evaporation for the daytime interval is measured in terms of the drop in water level. Means the initially how much depth of water is stored, that depth is measured, and later on at the end of the day, how much water has lost through this evaporation pan in terms of the depth. Also in terms of volume also we can decide, that we will see. But basically we want the evaporation in terms of depth, because we have all other parameters, that is the precipitation, infiltration, and the evaporation also, all in terms of the depth. Therefore we want this in terms of the depth. The observations are generally taken on daily basis. Regularly they are taken. After taking the measurement on each day, the water level in the pan is restored to a stipulated value by adding or removing required amount of water. Means after the day is over, if the water level in the pan is reduced, then for the next day it is again refilled till up to certain mark into this evaporation pan, and again next day at the evening the water lost is measured in terms of the depth. It is nothing but any cylindrical vessel of 1.2 to 1.8 meters dia, made up of certain metals like the stainless steel, like the brass, like the copper, so that it should not corrode. That is the basic thing. Its diameter is 1.2 to 1.8 meters and its depth is 0.3 to 0.25 meters, with open at the top, made up of the either galvanized iron sheet, or as I have told you, maybe aluminium sheet, maybe a copper sheet, maybe a brass sheet. Only the necessity is that it should not corrode in due time, because it always remains in contact with water. The water level within the pan is maintained between 5 to 7.5 centimeters below the rim of the pan. Rim means this topmost portion. Below this topmost portion of the pan or this plate, 5 to 7.5 centimeters from top, the water level is kept. Means if this depth is 25 centimeters, then water is stored up to 20 centimeters from the bottom. That is, it is kept empty 5 to 7.5 centimeters from the top. As I have told you, it is used to find out the evaporation during the daytime, because the solar energy or the sun acts for the evaporation in the daytime. We are using this evaporation pan to find out the evaporation from the water body. I think you are understanding. What we do, we put these evaporation pans, which is also called as evaporimeter, near the dam site, near the reservoir, adjacent to reservoir. Okay, so that we should have as equal atmosphere as reservoir. Adjacent to reservoir, one place is fixed and where this evaporation pan is located or fixed. But its diameter is 1.2 to 1.8 meter and all depth parameters, they are fixed. But that is not the exact representation of the reservoir. Okay, though we are adopting the evaporation value of this pan evaporimeter, but that does not 100% represent the conditions of the reservoir, of the dam, of the water body for which we are trying to get the evaporation losses. So therefore, for getting the exact value of evaporation from the reservoir itself, with the help of the pan evaporimeter or with the help of the evaporation pan, a pan coefficient is used. This pan coefficient is nothing but a ratio of actual evaporation from the reservoir divided by measured evaporation from the pan. Some practical analysis is done for 1 month or 2 months in the summer, actually measuring the loss of water depth in the reservoir for a particular temperature, and at the same time measuring the loss of water from the evaporation pan and finding out their ratio on, say, for 10 days, 20 days, 30 days. So you will get a constant value, or you will get an average value of this ratio, that is called as the pan coefficient. This is for that particular pan which is used near that reservoir. And this pan coefficient is used to find out the exact quantity of the evaporation. Means this pan, by multiplying this pan coefficient with the measured evaporation value from the evaporation pan, we will get the actual evaporation from the reservoir. Okay, I think everybody of you must have understood what is the use of this pan coefficient. I will again repeat in next 4 to 5 slides. There are 3 types of these pans commonly used. They are the sunken pans, they are the floating pan, and the surface pan. Again, I will recall you, friends, you must be holding your pen and the diary with you, and that today's date, what we have started today. Regularly, never remind me to recall you all these things, because we are discussing important topics, not only from our lecture point of view, but 100% from your exam point of view also. And also I talked with some of your visionary students from your future point of view also, from the MPSC, UPSC point of view also. So, and I being from the industry, I know which is important, on which point the stress is to be given. Okay. So, there are mainly three types of the pans that are commonly used. They are the sunken pan, floating pan, and surface pan. A note is asked on this, either of the three: sunken pan, floating pan, and the surface pan. Okay, now the first we will be studying about the surface pan. Then we will see about the floating pan, and then we will see about the sunken pan. So the first is called as the surface pan. It is initially developed in United States. Therefore, the name for it is given as United States Class A evaporation pan. Initially, it was adopted in our country also, and also today also we are, the pan developed in our country is almost same as this US Class A evaporation pan. As I have told you, it has a diameter of 1.21 meters and a depth of 25.5 centimeters. Again, its sketches are there. I'll be showing these sketches for next 2-3 slides. If possible, you can copy it down. It is made up of the unpainted galvanized iron sheet, or can be made up of the aluminium sheet, can be made up of the copper sheet, can be made up of the brass sheet. Where there is corrosion problem, it is made up of the monel sheet, or as I have told, other types of the sheets, non-corrosive. Water is filled in the depth of 20 centimeters, that is 5.5 centimeters lesser from the top. When the depth of water reduces to 18 centimeters due to evaporation, it is again refilled. Water surface level is regularly maintained, measured, that is daily measured with either hook gauge. A gauge is installed in this instrument, in this pan that I will show you. This pan is put over a wooden platform. This platform is shown at the bottom. This pan is put over a wooden platform of 15 centimeters height from the ground surface to allow the free circulation of the air below this pan. Means to achieve as nearer atmospheric conditions as they are in the reservoir or the pond nearby. Evaporation is computed as the difference between observed water levels on two consecutive days. Means in the morning and in the evening, or regularly at 6 o'clock in regular morning, if water is not needed to refill. Else take the reading at the beginning of the day, say at 5 o'clock in the morning before the sunrise, and take the reading after the sunset, so that there are no chances of the evaporation. So every day, either in terms of the depth, or sometimes what will happen, it can be computed from water added each day to bring the water level up to a fixed mark in the stealing well. Means how much volume of water is added. If that volume of water is added divided by the area of the container, we will get the depth. But basically, the depth of the water that has been added, that is more important. While computing evaporation, adjustment shall be made for any precipitation occurred during the period. Means not only evaporation takes place, but sometimes rainfall also will take place in the daytime. So this pan may get refilled due to the rainfall quantity. So as that rainfall quantity fills this pan and reaches to the 5 centimeters from the top of this pan, you have to take out the water. And you have to keep measurement of that water, how much water that has been taken out, either in terms of the volume or in terms of the depth. Okay, I think you must be guessing or you must be understanding, friends. We may have a situation wherein during summer or during the daytime, there are chances of occurrence of the rainfall. So this evaporimeter or evaporation pan may get filled with the water. In addition to loss due to evaporation, so that additional water that has been added due to the rainfall, due to the precipitation, has to be taken care of in terms of the depth of the water. Okay. Now, as we are moving into our Indian standard pan, where we in our India we use. Again, friends, these are the sketches at the bottom. And again, same type. It is the modified form of the United States Class A evaporation pan, almost same. It's a shallow vessel made up of the copper, whose thickness is 0.9 millimeters thickness, tinned inside. From inside, it is tinned with the help of the glazing tin and painted outside. The pan is 1.22 meters in diameter and 25.5 centimeters in depth. Its diameter is 1.22 meter or 122 centimeter and its depth is 25.5. Installed on a grill edge or the wooden platform of 10 centimeter above the ground surface above the ground, it is put at 10 centimeters. The pan has small steeling well. This is the steeling well inside the pan, in which a fixed point gauge, this is the steeling well it is called as, or here in sketch it is shown here, and in photograph it is shown here. This is used to measure the depth of water that has been reduced or that has been increased. Reduced due to evaporation and maybe increased due to addition of the water or due to precipitation. So this is called as the steeling well, in which a fixed point gauge with a vernier is installed to measure the level of the water. The water is initially kept 5 centimeters below the rim, that is the top of the pan. And as usual, the daily evaporation is computed as the difference between observed water levels in the pan. This is again the more elaborative or detailed sketch of that Indian type evaporation pan. Again, this is that rim or the steeling basin or steeling well. This steeling well is used with certain vernier micrometer scale and is used to measure the depth of the water which is lost or which has increased. And from top of this pan, 5 centimeters below this top, water is always kept at the beginning of the day. So now, again, that point where we discussed about the pan coefficient, I will again repeat that. I have told you at that time that evaporation recorded by the pan may differ from the lake or reservoir alongside it. The reason is depth of the exposure of pan above the ground, because the pan is located on a wooden platform shown here above the ground. And actually in the reservoir, water is stored below the ground and to certain depth. So therefore there may be difference in exact evaporation depth. So therefore, why we use the pan coefficient? Because the depth of exposure of pan is above the ground. Color of the pan, because we use the copper pan with tinning from inside. Height of the rim, that is the height is 25.5, and the dam may have a more very large depth. heat storage and heat transfer capacity with respect to reservoir, because reservoir has got larger surface area and the pan has got limited surface area. Also pan diameter, it's 122 centimeters, and reservoir has got large surface area. The vapor pressure conditions above the pan are different as compared to the reservoir, the wind speed and the water temperature. So therefore, due to these reasons, the lake evaporation will be less than the pan evaporation. To accommodate this or to adjust this, we use a pan coefficient. That pan coefficient is equal to lake evaporation divided by the pan evaporation, or the lake exact lake evaporation is equal to pan coefficient multiplied by pan evaporation. Because we take the reading of the pan, we want the reading of the lake, therefore lake evaporation is equal to pan coefficient multiplied by pan evaporation. And generally this pan coefficient is 0.8. Okay, I think everybody of you must have understood and noted these things. What is the necessity of the pan coefficient? Now the next is Kolaroro sunken pan. As I have told you friends, either or out of the three, one note is asked on this. So every pan is very important. This is also the same type of the pan. Only this pan is buried inside the ground adjacent to the lake. This pan is nothing but like the material is the same. It is below the ground level. The pan is 92 centimeters square in plan and 46 centimeters depth. It is buried into the ground such that the water level is at the ground level. It is buried in the ground so that the water level that is stored in this container or the pan is at ground level. It is unpainted galvanized iron sheet. The advantage is its radiation and aerodynamic characteristics are as closer to reservoir as possible. However, its big disadvantages are it is more expensive. It is more difficult to detect the leakages. If this pan leakages from the bottom, it's very difficult. And it needs more care to keep the surrounding area free from grass, dust, etc. Okay. So this much is sufficient from your exam point of view. Now the next is floating pan. Sometimes a note is also asked on this. So floating pan is also again similar type of the evaporating pans we have seen earlier. But this is actually kept in the reservoir as shown here. Either it is circular or it is the rectangular. Again, the fundamental is same. The water level in the tank is maintained at the same level as the water surface in the surrounding lake. It is supported by drum floats and is kept floating in the lake. Again, surrounding lake, while the rim of the pan is 7.5 centimeters above the water level. The floating pan used by the United States Geological Survey is square in plan as shown here, with a side of 90 centimeters, 90 by 90 centimeters rectangular and 45 centimeters deep. Or we can use circular. The basic fundamental is only we should know, we should get as close to the reservoir conditions as possible. The use of these pans is not very common. We use the first type, that is Indian standard evaporation pan. But this also can be used. We should have the knowledge of this. They are not commonly used. There are many operational difficulties associated with this type of the pan, because it is very difficult to operate it, because we have to float it. It needs to be accessible. We have to reach it to take the reading. Sometimes due to the winds, etc., or due to the waves in the reservoir, splashing of water from outside the tank or reservoir may come into the pan, or some water from the pan due to oscillation may come out and may go out into the reservoir. So this is the difficulty we may face. The pan coefficient for this type ranges from 0.7 to 0.82. Generally, it is 0.8. Now, some two methods we will see, water budget method and energy budget method. Again, as I have told you, the numericals are on the first type of that surface pan, that is Indian standard pan. These are important for writing the notes in the exam, and also if sometimes some numericals are asked, that are included in our notes, I will try to show here also. So water budget equation is a very simple equation wherein it is based on continuity of water flow. You know the continuity equation, you might have learned in your fluid mechanics. The water inflow is always equal to water outflow. A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. So the same fundamental is used, that whatever water that has entered into the reservoir or the dam or the river will be equal to the water which has got out from the reservoir. So therefore, using this continuity equation of the water storage, the evaporation is equal to the evaporation loss, or is equal to S1 minus S2 plus I plus O minus O minus OS. That we'll see what is. E is the evaporation loss. S1 and S2 are the storage at time 1 and 2.
आवाज नहीं आ रहा। सर आपके तरफ से ऑडियो म्यूट हो गया शायद।
हाँ अभी आवाज आ रहा है क्या?
यस सर, यस सर।
हाँ ठीक है ठीक है, लेट अस कंटिन्यू बिकॉज वी हैव लॉट ऑफ एनर्जी बजट मेथड इज दी. अभी आई थिंक यू आर व्यूइंग दी स्लाइड एंड लिसनिंग टू दी वॉइस. सो दी एनर्जी बजट मेथड सिमिलर टू दी दैट अर्लियर वाटर बजट मेथड वेर इन एनर्जी इनपुट एनर्जी इनकमिंग एंड एनर्जी आउटगोइंग इज बीइंग कंसिडर्ड. अगेन ए थियोरेटिकल टाइप ऑफ द कंसेप्ट वेर इन द कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन ऑफ द एनर्जी क्यू एन माइनस क्यू एच माइनस क्यू ई इज इक्वल टू क्यू थीटा माइनस क्यू ई वेर क्यू एन इज इक्वल टू नेट रेडिएशन एब्जॉर्ब बाय द वाटर बॉडी क्यू एच इज इक्वल टू सेंसिबल हीट ट्रांसफर टू एटमोस्फियर क्यू इज एनर्जी यूज फॉर इवेपोरेशन क्यू थीटा इज इंक्रीज इन एनर्जी स्टोर्ड इन वाटर बॉडी एंड क्यू इज द एडवेक्टेड और द एनर्जी कंटेंट ऑफ इनफ्लो एंड आउटफ्लो एनर्जी. तो बाई यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन अगेन बाय सर्टन ट्रायल एंड एरर कैलकुलेशन वी कैन फाइंड आउट द इवेपोरेशन लॉस. द एडवांटेज इज इट हैज इंक्रीजिंग एप्लीकेशन टू स्पेशल स्टडीज बट अगेन इट इज अ स्पेशलाइज्ड जॉब वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इट इन्वॉल्व ग्रेट डील ऑफ द इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड इट कैन नॉट बी रेडिली यूज्ड विदाउट मच डाटा. सो नाउ फ्रेंड्स विद दिस विल बी मूविंग ऑन टू द न्यूमेरिकल पार्ट. द फर्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल वी विल सी एंड वी विल टेक ब्रेक हियर. इट्स वेरी सिंपल बेस्ड ऑन द इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड इवेपोरेशन पैन और इवेपोरीमीटर. अगेन प्लीज रिमेंबर अबाउट द पैन कोएफिशिएंट आई हैव टोल्ड यू ट्वाइस द यूज ऑफ दैट पैन कोएफिशिएंट. द टेबल गिव्स द डेट वाइज फ्रॉम 1790 टू 7790 फॉर द 7 days द क्वांटिटी ऑफ रेनफॉल इन मिलीमीटर्स रेगुलरली and the water added. Water added means the water that has been evaporated because evaporated water has been added. Therefore, the water added means the water that has been evaporated. Okay. So, what has been asked after giving this, you have been given pan coefficient of 0.8. You calculate the daily lake evaporation, average evaporation for 1 week. Very simple, regularly asked examples in the exam. So, we can have this numerical in tabulation form like this. The dates are written here, 1790 to 7790. Okay, dates are here. Water added or taken out. Okay, water added or taken out. Both has to be entered or encountered for. Added means this water has evaporated and taken out means removed water means maybe this removal is due to rainfall. So this removal has not entered or has not taken part in evaporation. So this removed water we will not consider for evaporation. On the contrary, this we will delete or take out while considering the evaporation. Very important to understand. So water added, as has been here, due to water added, 12, 5, 2, minus 9 is water taken out, plus 1, plus 6 and the plus 11 means this much water is regularly added. To refill the pan below 5 centimeters from top, that is rim of the pan. Okay, during this period of from 17 to 77, there was precipitation on some 4-5 days, 6 millimeters on 27, 8 millimeters, it has been given here, 8 millimeters, 12 millimeters, 9 millimeters, 5 millimeters, and on 2 days there is no rainfall. So due to this rainfall also water has been added into this evaporimeter. But on this 4-7 rainfall is larger, 12 millimeters rainfall. So therefore 3 millimeters of the water is required to be taken out. So therefore we have taken its cognizance while calculating the evaporation. So therefore how much is the pan evaporation then? The water added regularly plus the rainfall. Okay, so on that first day it is 12 centimeters. On second day it is 5 plus 6, that is 11. On third day it is 2 plus 8, it is 10. On the fourth day it is 12 millimeters of the rainfall minus 3 millimeters of the water that has been taken out. When the sign in numerical is shown negative, means you have to understand that this much quantity or this much depth of water is taken out. Plus signs means this much water is added, or the refilled means this much water is evaporated. But minus sign does not show the evaporation. So therefore 12 minus 3 is equal to 9 millimeters. Rest is 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. 5 plus 6 is equal to 11. 11 plus 0 is equal to 11. So this is the total pan evaporation. Very simple. The such simple numericals appears in exam. So this is pan evaporation. Very simple. So now the lake evaporation. Lake evaporation, we know that the lake evaporation divided by the pan evaporation is the pan coefficient. Pan coefficient is given as 0.8. Therefore, lake evaporation is equal to pan coefficient multiplied by the pan evaporation. Okay, because lake evaporation conditions are different as compared to the pan evaporation. Pan evaporation is more than the lake evaporation. Therefore, we reduce it by multiplying the pan coefficient. So therefore, each value in this column is being multiplied by 0.8. So 0.8 multiplied by 12 is 9.6 millimeters. 0.8 multiplied by 11 is equal to 8.8 millimeters. 10 multiplied by 0.88. In the same way, all other calculations are done. You might be having in your notes the numericals, and you must be noting down in your notebook also. So this is the total daily evaporation. If we sum of all these evaporations of the reservoir, this is the sum of the total weekly evaporation from the reservoir. We have been asked to find out the average evaporation for 1 week. So therefore, the total evaporation divided by 7, that is weekdays, is equal to 8.46 millimeters. Is the average evaporation for the whole week. Okay, per day evaporation average. I will again repeat the numerical for your further clearance. These values are given. The daily rainfall as well as daily water added in plus sign, and the water that has been taken out in minus sign. Water added means, why the necessity of addition of the water? Because that much quantity of water has been evaporated in the earlier day. Means that much quantity of water evaporated. Therefore, to refill that evaporation pan, 5 millimeters from the top, we have to add this much quantity of water. So therefore, date wise, this much quantity, that is 12 millimeters first day, 5 millimeters second day, 2 millimeters first day, minus 3 millimeters on the next day, means that much quantity of water has been taken out, means this is not evaporated. Why? The evaporation was bit reduced. It's not actually reduced, but the pan has filled to its top due to the quantity of rainfall, that is 12 millimeters on that day. So therefore we have to take out certain quantity of water, that is minus 3 millimeters or the 3 millimeters. Rest is plus, that is the quantity of water added or evaporated. The rainfall quantity in the next column, the pan evaporation is equal to then the quantity in the second plus 3 plus the quantity in third column. That is 12 plus 0 is equal to 12, 5 plus 6, 11, 2 plus 8, 10, 12 minus 3 is this. All you must have noted in your notebook how these values have achieved. And then later on, we have found out by multiplying the lake evaporation constant, or the pan coefficient, it is called as pan coefficient multiplied by the pan evaporation will give you the lake evaporation value. And after summing this lake evaporation value for the week, we will get the total lake evaporation in the week. Then by dividing that the total days, 7 days, we will get the average evaporation for 1 week. So here we will take break. We will start in our next lecture the remaining part of this unit.